Your Honor, this is rather shocking. In fact, in my other friend, and I'm sure you can swear by the Bible, I have been pestering her every day, asking her what happened to her application. And the message I have consistently gotten since the filing of the application is this. The court says, let's wait, we shall be advised. Now, whoever took the file to court, Your Honor, that is the person who should take the flag. And I say this without any fear of contradiction. Okay. Because
what I mean, and I think this is now what I'm telling you, that is actually what happened.
Thank you, Your Honor.
I was sitting in the High Court. There was another matter I was seeing on the other side. When the file was brought to court, it was actually cornered. And yeah. There is no one who had an idea. So I don't even think I made any notes in the file. Because being a certificate, somebody will definitely
call
it up.
Your Honor, if you allow me just to make a comment. And that's why I began by saying the narrative that is being run. That choice of word was very deliberate. Yes. This is one of those matters that if one is not very careful, can very easily be used to send the wrong message. I do not know whether it was by sheer design or deliberate move by whoever brought the file to you and has consistently advised our team that we await your direction. Why do I say so? The smear campaign that is running against the DPP. Please, you just allow me to say this.
Address the issues.
Your Honor, this is central. This is
what I'm trying to say. I didn't say that I'm faulting you, but I say this is actually what happened. This file was brought to me that morning. Actually, the application was brought to me that morning. Together with four files in number. Yes. And I was told the two other files, an application for consolidation was made, but they were not withdrawn under Section 87A, so they remain in our records. So
yes,
I was told that the four will be mentioned together with it so that I can request the DPP to withdraw those other files from our record. Then I say, perfect, that is okay. Bring this file, this application, together with the file, and this number 18 so that I can give directions in the matter.
Yeah,
and they got the assistant.
Let me please.
And before we started the proceedings for that day, I directed the certificate. She called the file and the names. The prosecutors who were in court that day did not have an idea of what was there. So they did not have anything to say about the file. So I said, please the file aside.
Then the
court rules, there was no action from the end of the DPP.
Could I make a plea, Your Honor? I plead with you.
Yes.
Give specific directions on how certificates will be handled to your staff. Because I can tell you this, I am not an astrologer, I cannot tell when the moon will shine or not, but there is one thing I know about these kind of cases. Certain things don't just happen, and I am not accusing your court, far from it. Yes, far from it.
They did not keep the file in the registry, they actually brought the file to us.
Yes, and they made one mistake, which they must actually admit and apologize for.
Let me ask you, Mr. Muteti.
Yes, sir.
Who was the counsel that you petitioned?
One of these applications is signed by myself.
Who brought it in court on that particular?
Ms. Ocalo is here with me in court.
Did she come to court? Because you see, the nature of a certificate is once you present the certificate in court as counsel, you will not leave until you get direction. You do not leave until you get there. If it is a certificate, present the certificate in court. You don't leave until you get direction. Even when it is filed by a conscience in the matter, when you bring the certificate in court, even as counsel, you do not leave without getting direction on the matter. Whether it is certified in court or not, or what happens after that. So basically, the counsel who brought this matter from the DPP's office ought to have come back with some directions from the court.
Let me say this, you can face very serious frustration when you are following up a certificate.
You are a senior.
Yes.
Why would you face frustration?
The danger is this. If my learned friends, Mr. Kilukumi and Mr. Katwa Kigen, saw me emerging from your chambers, following up on an application, and you make the good mistake of granting my orders.
Okay, let's find a way forward out of this.
Yes.
Let's find a way forward so that we give you the application, the matter before us. But I just wanted to keep what happened.
Thank you.
I remember this matter coming before.
And I just want to clarify one thing before you proceed and give directions. We did not intend at all to have this matter adjourned on account of absence of counsel from the DPP. That is a commitment I am making with my line senior, Mr. Taibia. We have a team of 8 prosecutors ready and willing anytime to appear and prosecute any matter related to this issue.
Wait, I get your commitment.
Yes.
What I wanted to communicate is that we have now come to the court. No adjournment of these cases. The attendance that is brought needs a prosecutor. Because already there is another client who has said you are not interested in proceeding this. So the court cannot be known that we have to be fast. The issue of whether this file will be maintained, or both files will be maintained, or one file. And if, as you heard, the defense is insisting that the government does not want consolidation. So we have to deal with those two issues first. So meaning, today we cannot proceed with the matter. I think the manner we handle the matter previously, we need also to improve on our part. Particularly for the people who presented that application before us. I don't think if it's a certificate which symbolizes candidacy, it ought to have been, it ought to have taken the appeal now. They probably should have sorry, reasons why the application has not been had. And I think that has not been done. So I think it's on 8th of October 2021. And the court immediately to the file, the court, by the moment for the directions, in respect of the certificate, but do not proceed because counsel from the DPP was not in court. The prosecutor who brought the application, called to have written for the court direction, considering the nature of the application was a certificate. The nature of this application is that the hearing of this case cannot proceed today before the application is determined, hence today's hearing cannot be possible. Consequently, the director of the defense shall have 3 days to file the express points and the submissions and serve the same on the DPP by Friday, 22nd of October. Within 3 days after service, the prosecution shall file its written submissions. Consequently, the response by the defense and the submission shall be filed and served by Friday, 22nd of October 2021, while the prosecution submission shall be done by Monday, 23rd of October 2021. There shall be a virtual mention on the 26th of October 2021 at 9 a.m. to confirm compliance and fixing the date for the hearing. Defense counsel, including those who may not want the votes, if they want to put in their papers, they can do so better. Thank you very much.
John, can you just confirm the virtual meeting is on 26th of October?
Yes.
Okay. you have your kind of permission, can we exclude the attendance of the accused person because it's simply confirmation of a formula of submission?
And the attendance is virtual. If they don't want to log in, but if they necessarily log in,
Thank you.